Okay, so I'm gonna do something just a little bit different for this video. I'm gonna share a YouTube channel down below. I saw this probably about a year ago now. Samantha Stevens, her name is, and she makes these little fairy bottles and. She makes an awesome Tinkerbell clock. You have to go and see. I'll try and link that one below. But yeah, I'm going to follow her tutorial, I suppose. And I'm going to do this bottle. I'll probably do this bit in fast forward because I'm just going to literally glue these die cuts that I've cut out of black paper with some gel medium onto this glass, and I'm gonna have to hold it for a few seconds while it takes, so it's gonna take me a while. So I'll fast forward so you can just watch how I do it, okay?
Like a bird on a tree, I'm just sitting here. I got time, it's clear to see. From up here, the world seems small. We can sit together, it's so beautiful.
I'm going to use my tissues. Well, these are the bits of the napkins that don't have the patterns on. And I'm going to cover the whole bottle, give it a little bit of texture. I'm going to use the matte medium for that. And again, I'm going to fast forward it because that's going to get really boring. Really fast, so I'll see you in a moment.
Sometimes you need to go and take a step back to see the truth around you. From a distance you can tell. Thank you.
So I've just given that another coat of the napkin and dried it a little bit. It's still a bit tacky, but it's dry enough. Now I'm going to add a coat or two of gesso. So again, we'll fast forward through that. Dried overnight. As you can see, it's really obscuring the black figures now. So now we're going to add our colours. And I'm going to speed through again. Just add these different colours. I'm going to add a little bit of blue, light blue to the top. Cerulean. If I can get it out the tube. Let me finish that one. And a little bit of teal. To give that one a shake. A little bit of ultramarine. This one's quite old, so it's a bit. Up a little bit. There we go. And then I've got a bit of Payne's Grey, which I might use near the bottom. There we go. So, going to paint it. Okay, so, sorry if the light's a bit rubbish here, I've just got it this here because I'm going to spray the bottle now and I don't want it to go all over my room. So yeah, I'm going to use this Pastel Turquoise Aida Mist from 13 Arts and it should have a little bit of sparkle in it. think it's like a teal turquoise. Has it got a colour in English? No, it's made in Poland. I actually got this in a kit from Marta Lubkowska, Maromi Small Art. So have a look on her Etsy store. She might have some kits available. Okay, so she doesn't sell these individually. I know that because I asked her. Ooh. No. Doesn't want to spray. Sounds like it's trying to come up. There we go. And I'm not gonna. I just want it sort of uneven. I did try to sort of dry brush a bit of the darker blue on here so that it shows up the texture. So yeah. My computer's loading up there if you can hear that. I think that's all I'm going to get out of that, but that's okay, I didn't want a lot anyway. I just want to add a bit of a sparkle really, so I am going to have to dig out my Lindy's as well, I think. I don't know if the blue is going to be a bit dark, but we'll try it and we'll see. Okay, so I've got my Lindy's out. I've got Bachelor Button Blue, which actually is not that dark, so it looks like it might be fairly translucent. Also, I don't want it to be even anyway, so just a few little splashes here and there. Just want a little bit of shimmer, and I'm going to add a tiny bit of this Bells of Ireland green. Just think it'll go well with the tealy colours. Let's give it a bit of a blast with a heat gun. Don't mind if it dribbles a little bit, but let's just blast it. Wow, I don't know if you can catch that sparkle. It's got like a sheen. Okay. Zoom back in a little bit. Get out the way. Now then, let's add. Oh my goodness. Some decoration. So, these things are from my craft box for February. This one came out of the January one. And then I have these, which are baby white flowers, which I may use. And I also have some white ones that I might colour, maybe. I don't know. We might have enough here. I don't really want to overpower the bottle, I just want to add a little bit of something. I'm talking 10 to the dozen now. Right, gel medium. Where is my gel medium? In the drawer. Right. And I'm just going to pop it around the top of the bottle. I was looking to see if I could get something to go on the top of this earlier, but it's quite a wide opening, so I was looking at like little doorknobs, but too small, didn't look right. Just gonna pop a little bit of lace around there. There we go. Right, now I've got to try and figure out where I put my black die cuts so that I don't cover up anything. This might be easier if I actually put the lights in now. So, let's see. I've got these lights, they're little fairy lights, white ones. Bought them on clearance after Christmas. I'm just going to feed them into the bottle. Probably only 20 in the little battery powered lights. I thought it was going to be too many, but I have tried them and they do all fit in and they don't look too bad actually. It may take a bit of poking with a stick to get them in the right position so that you can see them all, but yeah. Well, you don't need to see them all, but they all light up the different areas of the bottle, you know what I mean, I'm sure. Can only just see some of them. Never mind. So I'm going to decide which I'm going to have as sort of the front of my bowl. I think there, maybe. So I can just that'll do. So yeah, I think the blue at the bottom is probably a bit too dark. So that's where we're having trouble seeing the mermaids. But that's okay. We can see these ones at the top. They're really pretty. Pretty, pretty. Yeah. So. Popping one of these on top. Now, would that look good inside a flower? or not? Oh. Looks okay. Yeah. Open that flower up, pop that in there, I might need to let that dry before I stick it on the bottle, I'm not sure if it's just going to fall out, it's gone very dark outside all of a sudden. I could use a glue gun for this. That might be easier. Oh. I'm going to stick. Do I want to use the glue gun? I just worry about the glue gun drying and sort of cracking and bits falling off, so. Pull the middle part of that flower out. And I'm going to spray it. Oh, that just splattered everywhere. Okay, I don't know what's going on with this, but it just doesn't want to spray, so. See what I'm doing, can you? It's so dark. just grab a baby wipe. And more flowers. No. Yes. Why I cut his hands off with the scissors. Do I want blue? I'm going quite dark with this one to match that dark one there. Where did I put my heat tool? That's down there, hang on. Okay. Now then. It took me a long time to wash this off my hands. Another quick dry. Leaf or two sticking out. Yeah. Put a blob on the stem. one more. Just want to finish off with shells. No. Ah, there. Right. And yep, oh, I escaped. Come on, in you go. In you go. Inside the flowers. Stick into my fingers. And then, once I've done that, I think okay, maybe not that flower. Okay, so I'll just clean that off and put it back. But yeah. I think I can call that done. It's a bit difficult in here, I know, because it's very messy. But I will try and put up some nice photos so you can see how that actually looks. Let's try and clear some space so you can see. I could do with a white background. But yeah. There we go. So that's a nice little sort of nightlight project that you can do with a glass bottle, you can do with a jar, a glass vase, anything. Anything glass. And there you go. Well, hope you enjoyed that video, and yeah, so thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye bye.